Hey Piggy people, so today's video I'm going to update you on Butter Pecan and also tell you about what Annabelle, the piggy on the left there, had to go to the vet for. She had to have a procedure done. So I'm going to start over here with Pecan, which everybody's going to be wondering about. So there's Miss Pecan. So Pecan's feeling a lot better on her antibiotics, and she's also on two pain meds. How are you? She's loving being out with her friends at all times. She's being more active, eating better, so that's excellent. She's pooping, peeing, and seems a lot more comfortable. So as long as she's happy, I'm happy. A lot of people were wondering, why am I not doing surgery for her? So I'm always a person that if there's a solution, I will do it, but I have to be reasonable. Pecan is 7, so I mean, she is a very senior guinea pig. When you do bladder stone surgery, you're going through the abdomen into the bladder, so you're making 2 cuts. It's very invasive. So a lot of people always say how invasive spaying is. So this is going into the abdomen but also the bladder, so it's even more invasive in my opinion than a spay. So that's pretty intense for a senior guinea pig. And the other huge factor is Butter Pecan has chronic digestive problems. So her GI tract without medication wants to go into stasis. So that's where her GI tract just doesn't move. And she also has bloat problems constantly. She's always getting stuff to deal with her gas. So she is at super high risk of not being able to come out of the anesthesia and post-op care properly. So she could be a pig that all those medications that are in her just make it so her guts will never restart or get going, and could be an absolute disaster. So it's already risky putting a healthy pig under. As you know, there are risks to anesthesia, and post-op care is super important to get them eating quickly, to get their stomachs moving, etc. So a piggy who already has 900 problems going into a surgery to deal with their stomach, it's pretty serious. So I've put pigs through bladder stone surgery, 3 of them. So the first one was Rugby, who was one of my first pigs that ever had a medical problem, and I didn't move quick enough to get him help for it. So he was really weak when he was going into surgery, and he passed right at the very end of his surgery. And second pig that went through it is Barnaby. Barnaby made it through just fine. It was a rough recovery because it's a serious surgery, but he made it through. Third is Butterscotch Ripple. Her stone was causing her such pain that she was going downhill huge, and it was either put her to sleep or try for surgery. We tried for the surgery and she did not make it through her post-op care, which I am not 100% surprised, because she was not in a good way going into the surgery. So I just feel for Butter Pecan that it would be cruel to put a piggy who is 7 through such a horrific surgery with not very good odds. And she's not at the point right now where she should be put to sleep or try the surgery. Maybe I would have a different view if it was that, but since right now she's improving on all her meds and seems happy and content, I would feel horrible putting her through that surgery and having her pass away horrifically trying to recover. So it's not an easy decision, because as you guys all know, I absolutely love Pecan to bits, and I want nothing more than to take that nasty stone out, but I am not going to put her through something so traumatic. If she didn't have the horrible gut problems, then it would be a serious consideration to put her through once, you know, the antibiotics have really done their job and she's in the best place that she can be in. But with her gut problems being so serious, I don't think some people really understand how serious her gut problems are, because, you know, you're not the one taking care of her, but it's literally a day-by-day thing that I'm battling with her just to be pooping properly and not being bloated and being comfortable. So, like, I've got it pretty down pat now that I'm used to what bothers her and how to give her meds, to make sure she gets something to eat when she gets her meds, to get her moving, to do any tubby rubs at the first sign of a problem, etc. So her days are pretty good, but like, you have to be on top of her crazy. So I hopefully that explains things to people, because I think everybody should know by now that I'll do whatever I can to help my pigs, but I also have to think about them, because the last thing I want to do, as I said, is to put her through something so horrible just to lose her. So I'd rather she gets to enjoy as much time as she can. And in the meantime, I'm giving her stuff that, you know, could dissolve stones. You always hear that. It did nothing for Apple, but I'm giving that stuff to her just because, what the heck? There's nothing to lose. So in the meantime, I hope you guys can see she is looking good. So now we will move over to Annabelle. So Annabelle is the piggy here on the right. So she had to get a bladder stone removed from her urethra. And I know people are going to say, why are your pigs having so many bladder stones? If I had the answer for you, then none of my pigs would be getting them. So here we just have small amounts of pellets, low calcium healthy veggies, not a ton, 80% hay for their diet, and fresh healthy drinking water. That's it. So I cannot answer why my guinea pigs are getting bladder stones. I have no clue. So anyway, Annabelle, she's very tricky, because she was not showing me any signs of pain at all. What was happening was she got bloated the one morning, and I couldn't really figure out why. So I had to treat her for bloat and help her get gas out. But the thing was, once I got the gas out later in the day, it would just be right back. And it was back again in the night and back again the next morning. And I was just like thinking, like, what is bothering her? Nothing has changed. So I looked her all over, trying to think of, like, okay, what's wrong? What's the matter? And there was this big bulge right down in her pubic region, right near where she pees from. So I felt it, and it felt hard inside and felt kind of swollen around there. So she went to the vet along when I was taking Pecan, had an x-ray. And there was a large stone in her urethra, almost out, but it seemed stuck. I'll show you a picture now. So, she wasn't doing that great. We were going to try to see if she could pass it on her own over the weekend, but she was already not doing that great because the bloat seemed to be from the pressure of the stone, must have been pushing so that gas and poop couldn't naturally come out easily. So it was getting to be just a battle of the bloat. She was really uncomfortable from that as well. So we decided to get her in super quick to the vet to get it removed. So they had to do what they did with Apple, where they make a cut in her urethra to allow it to come out. And now she just has to heal naturally. They don't put stitches down there. My vet said it would be very tiny and it could cause enough irritation that bad scar tissue could form, which you don't want her urethra constricted at all. You want it to stay as open as possible. So she is on pain medication and antibiotics, and I'm just to keep her cage super tidy. I can't even explain how tough she must be, because she was making no sound when peeing. She's not making any sounds now when peeing, and it has to burn. And she was eating, drinking, and acting totally normal. It was just the bloat that tipped me off that something was a little wrong. So I think it's insane how good guinea pigs can hide stuff. So I really don't know what to do different for diets. I'm going to try to feed even less pellets because I think that's the least important part of their diet. My vet suggested testing the water to see if it's like really hard water, but I don't believe it is. And then plus it goes through our filtration system that's reverse osmosis, I think. But anyway, I might do the test strips just to see what the water says for levels. I don't know. So we had very expensive vet trips. Very expensive. Because we had to have two x-rays, one for Pecan, one for Annabelle. Annabelle had a surgery. And then we have a whack load of medications. It was really pricey. So, yeah. Enough with the bladder stones already. It was horrible going through it with Apple. I'm thankful that Annabelle's is out. And now if by some miracle, Pecan's could vanish, that would be great. So, that's life with piggies. And where's little Buzzy? Oh, he spotted us. He's doing awesome. So he's very nervous for, like, if you're creeping, staring at him. But when I clean his cage, he's getting better for not freaking out so much when I'm spot cleaning. And when I do a full cage clean, I'll sit with him after and just kind of snuggle him. And he does great. So I can't wait for him to be able to be tried with the sisters, and I really hope that they take to him, because man, he'll have a lot of fun having a really large cage and some friends. In the meantime, he talks to absolutely everybody, and he's been lounging on his couch, which is so adorable to see him sleeping on a couch. And he sleeps in the cube as well, and he usually has his little front feet sticking out. I'll see if I can go around and... Oh, there he is. Hey, little Buzz. Hi, handsome man. We're so shy. Okay, guys. Anyway, I will talk to you guys later.
If you like watching guinea pig videos, learning how to care for us, seeing product hauls or reviews, or really anything else guinea pig, please subscribe. And make sure you hit that notification bell so you never miss a video. Down below, I've left two more videos for you to pick from, so keep on watching!